So last time we were talking about sort of an introduction to petroleum geomechanics, or why applications or problems in petroleum engineering that the field of geomechanics can be used to solve, and what's important. And we mentioned a little bit that the stresses in the Earth almost always arise from tectonic stresses. And it's those stresses that apply loads to well bores or fractures or whatever. So, you know, what we're going to cover in the next half hour is really probably certainly review from your geology class when you were a freshman, possibly a review from even high school. It's just structural geology. And if you took this course from a different professor, perhaps Dr. Olson, who hasn't taught this course in a long time, but used to, you know, he has a background in geology, and he stretches this structural geology part of the class out to like 2 weeks. I find it quite boring. I'm a mechanics guy. I want to look at equations. You know, that excites me. So, you know, we're going to have one lecture on structural geology, and then we're going to do mechanics. So, anyway. You know, the Earth, we all know this again from high school, is made up of a crust, a thin crust, mantle, and an inner core. Right? The crust, this picture is actually not even close to scale, because the crust is even much thinner than what it's pictured there. Right? What we most care about is in the crust and the uppermost mantle. So the lithosphere includes part of the upper mantle, because that while the mantle is molten rock, it's not a discrete transition. In other words, it's not a nice liquid substance and then there's a demarcation line and above that it's solid. It's not like that, right? It's sort of a varying viscosity from in the interior, a very low viscosity liquid material. And then as you approach the crust, then there's a lot more solids in the material and it becomes much more viscous. And so the crust is everywhere on the order of 0 to 100 kilometers deep. And the aerial density of the crust is about the same. So the aerial density would be like the mass divided by the area. And the aerial density is about the same everywhere, okay? Now, just like the picture seems to indicate, the crust in the ocean is much thinner. So it's like on the order of maybe 4 to 50 kilometers deep. And then over the continents, it's, you know, on the order of, 50 to 100 in most cases. So, if the aerial density is the same everywhere, but the crust is much thinner in some places than the other, how could that be? What do you think that is? Why is the crust much thinner, yet if I were to cut out any chunk of it, it's going to weigh as much, it's going to have the same mass as the same size chunk that's much thicker over the continents? Density or composition of the rock, and that has to do with the fact that most of the ocean crust is basaltic in nature, which is a higher density than the granite type rocks that are found over the continents. So